shot celebrity squares, and of course not forgetting Family Fortunes, where he just finished his last show, and now he's moving over to a new show on BBC very shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the star of the show, Bob Monkhouse.
My friends, what a pleasure. Who the hell's that? What a pleasure to see you here in this elegant Kasi. What a thrill to be here in the Pig and Whistle. It used to be called the Duck and Ferret, but people pronounced it wrong. What a pleasure to be here in the luxurious atmosphere of Barry Island. I'm delighted to see you. Hey, you're looking good. You chose the right time to come on holiday. Are you looking good? The sun has been turning you a beautiful color. And I'm feeling good too. I'm wearing the good suit tonight. I'm not wearing my usual underpants. I'm not wearing the usual see-through magnifying underpants. We all need help. Tonight, I've been sponsored. It doesn't hurt. Tonight, the Playtex people have asked me to announce I'm wearing the new Playtex cross your groin Y-fronts. Someone should have warned me, they lift and separate, you know. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and you smile, I can see I'm for you, you're for me, and for me, this will be such a ball. I wanna get you grinning, get the pig and whistle spinning, wanna see you smile, 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 smile. People say there's nothing to smile at these days. What a load of friar's bullsom. You look in the paper, you've got a smile. The news is all there. Mrs. Thatcher has had an eye operation. I'm surprised she let them operate. I thought she wanted a blind eye to turn to the unemployment figures. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and you smile, I can see just what you had for tea, but your smile is the key to my heart. Never mind unemployment, they're still striking at British Leyland. That's in the news today. Another little strike coming up at Leyland. Oh, yeah. Headline in the Sun this morning said 31 shop stewards mount boycott. I thought he'll never play cricket again, that fella. I drive a British Leyland car. I do. I bought one deliberately because I thought the walking will do me good, and it does. Do you know that? I came through Cardiff tonight. Oh, what a city that is. There's a sense of humour in Cardiff you find nowhere else in the world. I came through, my wife said, for God's sake, pop in that grocer's, get a loaf of bread. I went in a grocer's shop, 8 o'clock this evening it was open, and a typical Welsh sense of humour. Typical Cardiff character behind the counter. I said, I want to buy a loaf of bread. He came straight back with an answer. He said, we are not having any bloody bread this time of night. We're not running a bloody bread. What do you think this is? Is it bloody bakery? All we've got left is muffins. I said, what's the difference? He says, there's 2 F's in muffin. There's no F in bread. Get out of the shop. Yeah. I want to see you titter. See you spill your bitter. I want to see you smile, 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 smile. Well, if Lord Lucan came back, if Enoch slowly turned black, you'd have to smile. Yeah, smile, well, smile. If Captain Mark felt abused each time he jumped and refused, you'd have to smile, smile, smile. Do you remember David Frost? He once was a hit. He's out of TVAM now, but he's not worth a shilling. Well, it's easy to see, you're just as mucky as me. And that's the famous Butlins style. Hey, for the biggest smile here, I'll even buy you a beer that made you smile, yeah. Smile, well, smile, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. What a pleasure to be with you. What a privilege to be here. I tell you, I walked in here today. It's been warm today. It's been warm all week. It was tragic, actually. I drove down through Wales. I saw a cow lying on its back trying to give itself a shower. It broke your heart. That's the warm weather. It's been marvellous. Having a bit of warm weather. Unbelievable. And in here tonight, of course, they're selling the beer. Everyone at the bar, could you look at me, please? Could you look at me, the customers at the bar? Thank you. Okay, bartenders, you can start stealing now. See, They've got to sell the man's. Oh, they've got the man's beer here. I can't drink the stuff. Banks's, which is the local one here in South Wales, Banks's, and the man's is too strong for me. I come from a little county down in the south called Kent, and there we only drink Watney's Red Barrel. You can drink 19 pints of that and pass the breathalyzer. It's weak stuff. But here, the fellas are getting these pints down them. I can't believe it. I had a pint of man's beer tonight. I was halfway through it. I thought, what am I drinking this for? My head was going. It tasted like something you'd sit in for an hour to try and soak a tattoo off your ass. I can't do that. I can't take it, but there's fellas here who can drink that kind of thing. Oh, I wish I could. And then they're nipping the gents. That's the finest room in the place. Do you know, there's a lot of talk in this country about the European Economic Community, the common market. Should we be in it? Should we come out of it? There's only one true common market. It's that humble little room marked gents. When you're in there, it doesn't matter whether you're German, whether you're Dutch or Danish, whether you're French, Belgian or Italian. When you're in there, European. And that's the only thing. Well, you've missed nothing in the way of news this week by being on holiday. There's been nothing of interest whatsoever. Red Ken Livingstone, that publicity-seeking little nerd who runs the GLC down in London, he's received Gerry Adams. He's the MP who was elected over in Northern Ireland for the IRA, for the Sinn Féin. And, of course, Ken Livingstone, he was over there. Do you remember? He went over there to meet with them, came back saying, they ought to put up a statue to me in Belfast. I thought, put it up in Trafalgar Square, let the pigeons speak for all of us. This... Anyway, yesterday he made a speech saying we ought to bring all our troops out of Northern Ireland and all our lads back from the Falklands. So if you saw the Star today, the Daily Star, they had a headline saying Red Ken is caught with his pants down. I thought, that's a shame, it'll make it easier to hear what the man's saying. So, and the other news story today is Nkomo, Joshua Nkomo. He said he wants to stay here permanently. He doesn't want to go back to Matabele land in Zimbabwe, because he's no longer friendly with Mugabe. 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 Spelled backwards, Ibagum. Now. You see? Things are a bit different out there since it was Rhodesia. I know they had to change things as the voting wasn't fair. Oh, no, the blacks have bigger majorities. I always thought that was just a rumour, but apparently it's the truth. Yeah, except in the forces, they have white officers with black privates. Now, when I read that, I thought... Funny place to get sunburn. Anyway, what a pleasure to walk out here tonight. I walk out. How are you, ma'am? Did it go well? You couldn't get a jacket like the others. What a shame. Jeff's the leader. Jeff's the leader. It's not that he's in charge, but he finishes every number three bars ahead of the others. So he's entirely just one single pedal. He's a big lad. Take your hands out of your lap or pay amusement tax. I get you an agent. You can stop handling yourself. Am I on echo? Is there an echo on? Are you well tonight? This is our other Jeff. We have two Jeffs. That's a lovely bass guitar. It is lovely. The way this boy plays the bass guitar is art. Art with a capital F. Have you listened to this? It's a lovely bass guitar, Jeffrey. It is nice. Hold it up for the people to see. Admire it, admire it. Hold it up. Ah, aren't you glad you wrote that letter to Santa Claus? Yes, you're glad. Look at him smile. Aren't they lovely at that age? And who have we here? Little Blue Eyes. Oh, I hate to tell him. Oh, there's vandalism everywhere you go. Look what's happened to his drum. Somebody's ripped out this side of his drum. Does he know? Somebody's ripped out this side of your drum. Oh, you knew. What a shame. It's all gone. There's something in here. There's a pillow in here. A pillow in his drum. A midget has been sleeping in his drum. An incontinent midget has been sleeping in his drum. I never make jokes about midgets, man. Midgets only come up to your waist, and if they bite you, you're in dead trouble, I'll tell you that. The worst sight in the world is a midget walking away from you going, I bring you here for advice. What a pleasure to see you guys. Really, I am not merely turning around because I admire you, not out of sheer bravery. As soon as I arrived here, the head of entertainment, Mr. John Wilson, head of entertainment, Butlins Barry Island. Have you met him? A legend in his own mind. This fella... very sexy. So he tells me, I can't see it, can you? I can't see it. He reckons he's sexy, but you know, you've met fellas like that, haven't you, girls? Fellas who think that they're sexy. Oh, well, yeah, it's all he's in his mind. He gets randy driving towards tunnels. Do you know what I'm saying? He'd jump on anything that's got a pulse. Don't take my word. Don't just believe me. Ask the girls who work here. Ask the girls. Say to these lovely girls here, say, John Wilson's coming. They go, oh, hands are everywhere. His sex life is in fits and starts. If it fits, he's... Oh, yeah. So... He said there'd be a little drinky poo on the stage for me. Christopher, watch my lips. They said there would be a... Oh, is that it? John, is that mine? Is this mine?
No, no, hang on.
What?
That's mine.
What? Pardon?
That's mine.
Say it again, Jeffrey.
That is mine.
This is Jeff's.
It's Jeffrey's, everybody. Everybody, look, it's Jeffrey's.
What made him do it in a glass and bring it out here? Hi, folks. This is Sip. Sip is the name of the new soft drink that you can't spell backwards. Is it really yours, Jeff? You can sell your organ, your monkey's dying. Can I have a little sip of it? Can I?
Yes.
Ah, I'll buy you a large one later tonight and a drink to go with it.
Oh, wow.
Do you girls want to go off and rest? You do. Are you enjoying yourself tonight? Well, inform your face. Now, why don't you... Why don't you go off and have a little lie down? Because you look shagged. Go off and have a lie down. They're playing without benefit of rehearsal or talent. Go and lie down. Have a wonderful time. Rest, slip off your shirts and have a nipple counting contest. You love that. Wonderful man, fine human beings. Have they gone? Sick, perverted lunatics. The three of them, they are sick. Those men are sick. That one on the one in the white jacket, Jeffrey. Oh, he's the worst. He's ill. He closes his eyes when I kiss him. Why? Why? I knew him years ago when he worked in the fun fair here on Barry Island. Oh, yeah. He was one of the rides. I could tell you stories. There's a lot of it about. Did you hear about the gay Arab terrorist who blew up his friend? He went, did you like that up there? Lovely mental picture, that. Some mad Arab oil sheikh going, ooh, that's good, Ali, ooh. Because the sand gets everywhere out there. Anyway, what a pleasure to see you. This one is no better. This one here, the other Jeff, on the bass guitar. Did you see the way he walks? He walks lopsided like that. Did you notice as he went off? Have a look when he comes back. When he comes, don't stare. He'll know I've told you. Have a glimpse. You know how to glimpse, don't you? He's like peeping. You go like that. And you'll see he walks like this because he's got no toes on his left foot. It's his own fault, darling. Don't feel sorry for him. He tried to cut his nails on the cheap. They've got a little electric fan in their room and he's sitting there with his shoes and socks off and he went, ooh. Tried to cut his toenails with it. Boom! The air was filled with the blur of flying piggies. He felt no pain. He was sitting there zonking back the liquor. Stoned out of his brain, singing Toot Toot Tootsie Goodbye. Don't feel sorry for him. Don't feel so he pulls the birds when he tells him he's got a foot and a half. They say, pardon? Oh, well. He does well. He does well. What a pleasure being with you tonight. May I drink to you? I hope you're having the holiday of your lifetime. This is the time to have it. Beautiful weather in this part of the world, here in Wales, in South Wales. Isn't it lovely in Wales? I love Wales. I love going to the valleys. Is there ever so religious in the valleys? You go north and you turn left. When you see the greengrocers selling Granny Smiths wearing knickers, you know you're in the valleys. May I drink to you, my friends? Drink to whatever you believe in. Here's to the German virgin, Gesundheit. Do you know what I think we ought to do? Don't bother with the small ones. What I think we ought to do is drink to whatever you want to believe in. Whatever gives you the most pleasure in life, we'll drink to it. What gives you the most pleasure in life? Is there anybody there? Knock once for yes, twice for no. What gives you the most pleasure in life? Sex, gentlemen here. Finally, getting it out. Sex! Finally came alive. A gentleman here believes in sex. It's the most fun you can have without laughing. Can you hear me all right at the back? No? How could you answer the question? Anybody here believes in sex? Any lady believe in sex? Yes! If we can get these two on the stage, you're going to see the wildest Thursday night show you ever saw in your whole damn life. Why not? It's a beautiful thing. Thank you, God. God gave it to us. The Lord gave us sex. Let nobody go. Let nobody disapprove. The Lord gave it to us. The Lord meant us to have it. The Lord knows your mind, sir. The Lord can look down through the roof of this place and read your mind. He knows as you puff sedately on that pipe what you plan to do to that beautiful young girl beside you. Yes, he does. And he can look down through the roofs of chalets. He will recognize the back of your head in a couple of hours' time. The Lord. So whatever you do, do it well. For God's sake. Don't bore him. Sex is a beautiful thing between two people. Between five, bloody fantastic. So I'm told. Only know what I've read over the years in Cliff Richard's diaries. But you see, what? Cliff Richard, I admire him. He's marvellous, that Cliff Richard, isn't he? My God, he's wonderful. I love reading about all the stars. On a Sunday, do you get the Sunday papers? I can't wait to get down on a Sunday morning to the doormat. I pick up my copy of the Screws of the News of the World. Read all the stories. There they are. Next Sunday, I can't wait for that. The Sex Secrets of Pamela Stevenson. That should be good, shouldn't it? They call her Stevenson because she goes like a rocket, apparently. All in there. And Cliff Richard, last two Sundays ago, Cliff Richard was featured in the Sunday Mirror. Did you see that, girls? They said he will marry tennis star Sue Barker before the month is out. Now, I ask you ladies here tonight, do you think Cliff Richard will marry Sue? 100 people surveyed. I can't see it myself. Little Cliff, he doesn't even know what he wants to be when he grows up, for God's sake. Some say Olivia Newton-John. But, no, I can't see little Cliff marrying a tough, sinewy little athlete like that Sue Barker. My God, two sets hit with her, he'd be asking for new balls. Am I wrong? It's Wimbledon, isn't it? It gets him whipped up every year, Wimbledon. It was good this year. I enjoyed it. Billie Jean King was marvellous again. 39 years of age, she got to the semi-finals. Oh, I'd like to be like Billie Jean King. I would, fit and healthy and able to pull the birds. See? Each to her own taste, I mean. That's what she likes. It's made her a star, Wimbledon, back in America. She could do any television commercial she wants to. She could name any product to advertise. And she's chosen Snap-on tools. I wonder why. What a puzzle. Bye-bye. Some of these are jokes, others are puzzles. That was a puzzle. Shall we work on them together? See, I think it's marvellous to read about these stars. I love it. Sometimes I see the headlines. I don't know what they mean. I came back, I'd been abroad. I knew nothing about that racehorse, Shergar, getting stolen. First thing I saw was a headline, £15 million stud kidnapped. I thought, Christ, we'll never see Bruce Forsyth again. His obvious thought, because he's a hell of a lad, isn't he? That Brucey, he's unbelievable. The way he pulls the birds, and what, I like the man. I'm not going to rubbish him, I'm not going to knock him, just because he's been rude about me in the papers lately. That makes no difference. I admire Bruce, I've known Bruce, good God, how many years. I knew Bruce the first time he had hair, that long ago. Now, what is that thing he's wearing on his head? Does anybody know what that is? What is it? What is it, a head warmer? What is it, a filleted coconut? What's he wearing? Is it the third shredded wheat that he couldn't eat? Is that what it is? What is it? What can it be? Why is he wearing it? Does he know it's there? Has somebody told him? We don't know, of course we don't. If somebody did that on your head, you'd wipe it off, wouldn't you, sir? But he likes it, it keeps him happy, and it pulls the birds. My God, he pulls the birds. Look at the ladies in his life. His second wife was Anthea Redfern. What a little darling, what a beauty. She did well when they broke up, you know. Oh, because Bruce was having it away, so she split up with him, had good lawyers. Do you know what Anthea got out of the breakup? No, you don't, because it was never in the papers, I'll tell you. Anthea got the house down in Wentworth, got to be worth 200,000, I kid you not. She got both the cars, the roller and the Jag, and she got 22,000 quid a year. That's what Anthea got. And Bruce, Bruce got everything he could remember in 45 seconds. Oh, it's a tough world, darling. And custody of the cuddly toy. Now, have you seen the latest wife? Have you seen the one he married this year? Unbelievable. She's 25 years of age. She used to be Miss Peru. Yes, Miss Peru, an ex-Miss Universe, ex-Miss World. She's 25 years of age. He's 57. He's 57. That's not sex. It's the old grey whistle test. Amazing. Can you imagine? 57, and he had a four-week honeymoon with her in Lourdes, I should imagine. And it's envy talking, darling. This is envy talking, because I envy the man, my God. See me going 4 weeks with a 25-year-old beauty queen, my God. Do you like trying to push a lorry up a hill with a rope? Ever tried to save marshmallows in a money box? You'd know what I'm talking about. My sex life, that's it. You see, I'm not a lover, I admit it. I used to think I was a bit of a lover, a bit of a Jack the Lad. Found out about 3 years ago I'm no lover. About 3 years ago, I caught a peeping Tom booing me. I thought, that's it. Some fellas, they're lovers, they're natural lovers. There are fellas here in the pig and whistle Butlins Barry Island tonight who are great lovers. I can see it. There's virility in the room. Any girl here tonight, because the fellas are modest, any girl here tonight who's with a fella who's a great lover? Yes. Yes, lady there says, yeah. You're boasting for him, sweetheart, and I'm proud to hear it. What makes you a great lover, sir? Won't you tell us your secret? What makes you such a great lover? He doesn't answer. He sits there silently, licking his eyebrows. We'll never know his secret. What? What now? You're making up your own jokes. Now, if he can breathe through his ears, good luck to the man. Now, all I'm saying is, for those of us who are not great at the bedroom game, you have to be satisfied with television. Of course, you're on holiday, you're lucky you can miss the worst of the television. It's going to rain. Oh, that was you. And if you want to take pictures, you're welcome. If you want my good side, I'll show it to you. I don't mind. Fact is, you're not missing much on TV. What's your favorite TV show? We'll drink to it tonight. Name your favorite TV program. Did you hear that? Two people said Family Fortunes. Two people said Family Fortunes. I paid for five. Where's the other three buggers? Thank you for mentioning Family Fortunes, darling. Thank you for mentioning it. I'm just sad to be leaving it. The show I did 5 weeks ago, the last of the current series, that's the last Family Fortunes I'll ever do. You have the biggest, warmest eyes I've come across in South Wales. As of September, Family Fortunes will be hosted by Max Bygraves. And, oh, come on, he'll be terrific. He's had all those records he's sold in Australia. Max, oh, his swing-alongs are very big down under. And he'll be great on Family Fortunes, will Max. He'll be terrific. The only problem he'll have is at the end, giving the money away. Give it back, give it back. He's still got white fibres. Man, oh yeah. Max a little bit tight. I knew the first time I saw him. He was swimming under a toll bridge. I thought, hello. We bumped heads. Anyway, the fact is, he's taking it over and I'll miss it. I'll miss it. The old Family Fortunes. My favorite part about Family Fortunes is the surveys. Because as you probably know if you've ever seen the show, we send out researchers nationwide with our questions. They ask 100 people nationwide each of our questions. They come back with 100 answers. We stick the answers in the computer, Mr. Babbage. Nobody wins a penny till they come up with answers that match the ones we got on the survey. And some of the answers we get on the survey, you wouldn't believe them. They're even dafter than the answers we get from the bloody contestants on the program. You've got to admit, we have the thickest contestants of any game show. I can't believe it. I'm stood there. I'm next to them. It's all right for you sitting at home. I'm right beside them. There was one 7 weeks ago. Name something that uses microchips.
A fish fryer.
And I'm standing there going, good answer, good answer. When what I really want to say is, cop this. Why they put the desk there, so I won't break my knee. I tell you, it's weird. And some of the answers we get on the survey, we sent out a researcher. This researcher had to go out nationwide and ask 100 long-distance lorry drivers, do you ever pick up any casual on the road? And 20 long-distance lorry drivers said, no, never. And 20 said, sometimes. The other 60 gave her a fiver each. She did well, this researcher. Now, she'll be on the M4 tonight, I'll guarantee you. See, that's a great game. You talk about the oldest profession, it's in the Bible. That's it. Being a hooker, being a call girl, that's a great business. You've got it, you sell it, you've still got it. That's a good business. I'm in a pub tonight, in Barry, just up the road, off the island, in a little pub called the Rat and Handbag. Smart. There's a girl on her own, down from Yorkshire. Anybody here from Yorkshire? Bravest people in the world come from Yorkshire. You have to be to drink Tetleys. There's a Yorkshire lass sitting at the bar. I thought, I'll try my luck. I'm on my own. Why not? See if it works. I moved in on a girl's. I used the charm like a sledgehammer. I showed no mercy. I said, good evening. Good evening. I know, I know. Your eyes melted then, Pet. Do you know that? Can you take it head on? Good evening. Your knicker elastic went. I heard that from here. I said, do you like cocktails? She said, yes, tell me one. So I told her one. She didn't laugh. She didn't laugh.
She said, what do you do for a living?
I said, I'm a surgeon for insects. Would you allow me to show you the inside of a fly? It might have worked, it might have worked.
She said, do you want to bet? I said, I'll lay you 10 to 1. She said, no, lay me 10 to 12. I want to be asleep by 1.
I realised then she was on the game. She was only on the game. I only got £5 in my pocket. I said, are you going to charge me?
She said, no, I'll walk slowly towards you if you're nervous.
And I knew I was coming here, so I didn't get involved, but we talked for half an hour. How interesting. Have you ever talked to any girl in this line of business? Sir, have you ever discussed anything that... you're with one, I beg your pardon. He chose well. It's fascinating. She told me, I don't know how you girls put up with some of us fellas. Kinky, kinky. She's got some customers. I couldn't believe the story she told me. She's got this fella, comes down here to Barry, comes down from Merthyr Tydfil, comes down 3 times a year, says he's a lonely shepherd, got no sheep. That's his cover story. Bungs a £50 in onces, in £1 notes in the hand. That's still money, isn't it, when you don't pay tax? £50 in the hand. You know what his kink is? You know what he likes to do? He likes to make love in a coffin. In a coffin. I did that, Pet. I went, hey. The lady did that, went, hey. I did the same. I went, hey.
She said, oh, grow up, she said. If he likes to make love in a coffin and he enjoys it, let him, bless him. I don't mind it.
The pallbearers bloody hate it, mind. Finish. I said, are you doing well in Barry, in this line of business, in the middle of a recession? She said, am I doing well? If I had another pair of legs, it'd open up in Port Talbot. I thought, well, you can't fault that. You know, sometimes on those surveys, we used to ask 100 people a question, we'd get 100 answers, and we still didn't know what they really thought. Yes, They'd answer us, 100 answers, and we still couldn't see into their minds. We asked 100 people, do you think the British public is becoming less polite? And 20 said no, they didn't think so. And the other 80 said piss off, so we'll never know what they thought. Ironic, isn't it? Well, I had to get out of that show eventually. I've been doing game shows, like Brian said when he introduced me. I've been doing them for so many years. Before 4 years of Family Fortunes, I had 4.5 years on Celebrity Squares. Do you remember that? God, what was it really? What a load of rubbish. Just a giant game of noughts and crosses, or as the Irish call it, circles and signatures. Good luck, good luck. Good luck, good luck, good luck. I must tell you this. We had an Irish contestant on that show once. I'm all right telling you this, aren't I, here in Barry Island? There's nobody here with Irish blood tonight, is there? Oh, my God, I never knew. I never knew. Have we Irish folks in here tonight? Oh, it's great, it's sticking out, but it's desperate, it's brave and good. Do you come from the north or the south? The north is the top bar. Does that help in any way? Where are you from? Cork. Did you say Cork? Ah, it's beautiful in Cork. It's beautiful in Cork. It's even better in plastic. Have you ever tried it? Oh, you haven't? Oh, I'll meet you later. Leave your chalet key with Brian. I'll bring the rubber womble suit and the kipper. We'll have fun. I don't do Irish jokes. You hear some comedians, they do these jokes about the Irish being tick. Oh, yes. You hear them do jokes like, how do you get a one-armed Irishman out of a tree? You wave to him. I don't do that. I don't do those jokes. I was going to tell you a story, a true story about an Irish contestant. I wouldn't dream of telling that story now. Well, all right, but just a second. We've got friends here from Ireland. I don't want to embarrass them. I'll tell you what, I'm supposed to be a professional. If I can twist the story in such a way that it doesn't give racial or ethnic offense to our friends with Irish blood, would that be okay with you? Yeah, yeah, right. Just give me a moment to think. I've got it. We had this thick Welsh git on the program. Somebody here from Wales? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Careful, if there's 6, they form a bloody choir. It's lovely to see you from Wales, isn't it? I love the things they say in the Welsh language. So they say lovely things to the tourists in Wales, like Yaki da, Sospen bach, and there's nicely your cottage is burning, isn't it? Oh, it's a lovely language. I don't think the English, the Scots, and the Irish appreciate the beauty, the poetry of the Welsh language. The double L, for example, in the Welsh alphabet is a single letter. It's pronounced ugh. Isn't that beautiful? Ugh. How long since you last heard that, sir? Ugh. Long time. Me too, me too. I've just come down through the length of Wales. I came down from Butlins. Puch. Isn't that beautiful? It's easy to remember. If I drove back up, I could easily remember how... You can remember how to pronounce it. Simply imagine yourself starting from the lovely fishing town right here on the south coast of... I'm sorry, I do beg your pardon. Go through the centre of Wales, you pass through the lovely market town of... And eventually, you wind up in the north at Butlins. At Butlins. Really? The only person born to speak Welsh was Donald Bleeding Duck. Oh. But the double L really is pronounced ugh, which accounts for the fact that when Norman Tebbit was recently in Swansea and made a speech saying that Tory government policies were bringing wealth to Wales, you could distinctly hear a distant cry of bollocks. (Laughter) What I love about doing game shows is I don't have to travel to meet folks. Because when you're the host of a game show, people travel to meet you. And I get to meet people from all over this country and all over the world. We had a Chinese family on last year. That made me nervous. Because Chinese people make me nervous. I can't explain. I think it's because there's 100,000 million of them. Do you know that? There's 100,000 million Chinese. That's just over here running chip shops. God knows how many of them. You know the reason there's 100,000 million, don't you? Because they've got no form of birth control. Absolutely none. They don't have the pill. They don't have the coil. All they've got is an ancient law laid down by the Mandarins thousands of years ago. A Chinese father and husband is allowed 3 kids. If he tries to have more than 3, thump, they kick him in the credentials and he's out of the running. I'm trying to put it delicately. I'm trying to explain it nicely. For the ladies, they stop him becoming a father. A quick oriental Frankie Vaughan in the family jewels, and he's out of the running. Are you with me? Hey, that's the original Chinese takeaway. Now, that's evolution for you. That's why Chinese fellas have developed squinty eyes and prominent teeth. It comes from thousands of years of going, fool! I had to get out of game shows. People don't look at me anymore because I've done all these shows all these years. I mean, Family Fortune, Celebrity Squares. I used to do one for 7 years called The Golden Shot. Ah, nice. How nice of you to say shot. Not everybody does. But how wonderful that you remember it. But you see, people don't look at me anymore and say, that's old Bob. He tells jokes. No, they look at me and they go, prizes. He's got prizes. If I'm walking down the main road of Barry tomorrow morning, if I ask a fella the time and he gets it right, he'll expect a bleeding food mixer. So the BBC's asked me back to do a show. Oh yes, from September on, I take on the show. It used to be called Des O'Connor Tonight. We're changing the title, it seems wise. And I can do it. You've seen Des O'Connor Tonight, haven't you? I can do that, can't I? It's not a difficult job, is it? You just sing a song and laugh for 45 minutes. I can do that. I've been on the show once, had a little accident. You didn't see it, did you? Did you? Oh, bugger me. I had a zipper on a new suit open all by itself. Oh, it was embarrassing, my God. I was sitting there talking to Des, and the zipper must have opened while I'm sitting there. And Des suddenly says, stand up, Bob, tell a few jokes. I said, I will, Des. And I started noticing laughs were coming in the wrong places. I didn't mind the laughs, it was the woman in the front row going, oh, bless him. I said to Des, how could you leave me out there for 2 minutes with my zipper opened? He said I wasn't worried. Dead men don't fall out of windows. I could have killed him. So I'm looking forward to doing the show. I hope you'll watch it. It starts at the end of September, and then I do another game show on Saturday night. Oh, that's great. I'm looking forward to it. I've never not wanted to do a show. I've been in this game 37 years, and I've looked forward to every show I've ever done. Well, that's not entirely true. There was one show I never wanted to do. This Is Your Life. I always swore blind I'd never get involved. Here on this Thursday night, I'm here to tell you, it's exactly 16 months since I got caught. And I swore I would never get caught, because I thought my wife would tip me off. Did she, hell? Not a bloody word. The marriage was going through a sticky patch. I didn't know she was trying to keep the secret. She was trying to, and she was nervous from it. So she sort of throws up. You know what I mean? The marriage went inert. How can I express it? Inactive. Do you know what I'm saying? If my head had been blown off, she couldn't have identified the body. Are you with me? I was thinking of getting a vasectomy. It didn't seem fair to be using live ammunition on a dead target. So I got caught. Eamon with the red book. Oh, you torture will go on somewhere else, but you're not. People say, is that a shock? When Eamon comes up to you with the red book, is it a shock? Yes, it's a shock. People say, but it's a moving experience. Yes, it's that sort of a shock. If you're wearing the brown trousers, you're just lucky that day. Now, they whip you off to the London Theatre, and that's where they do it. And of course, I'm sitting there, I'm in two minds. Part of me squirming with embarrassment, but the other half's going, hey, because I look like Jack the Lad. For the first time in my life, I looked like a bit of a lover boy because sitting opposite me were beautiful women. And the implication is, isn't it, that they're involved in your life in every possible way. And there's Jenny Lee Wright and Lisa Goddard, Barbara Windsor, Diana Dawes, Pat Coombs. Well, you can't win them all. Come on. Funnily enough, she was the only one I'd actually... What am I telling you for? Anyway. I was just praying my first wife wouldn't come out. She'd have told them I was no lover. My first wife, she knew on the wedding night that she was the first real live woman I'd ever gotten to bed with. She knew. As soon as I tried to inflate her, she thought, hello. I was good that night. On my wedding night, I was sensational. I may have never had any experience, but I was fantastic. My passion was insatiable. When finally my virility was sated, I fell back upon the pillow, lit a cigarette, Craven A cork tip, I can see it now. And I said to my bride, well, Mrs. Monkhouse, how do you rate me as a lover? And I can see her now, misty-eyed, as she turned to me and she said, bleeding pathetic. How could she possibly have formed an opinion in less than 3 minutes? I ask you that. We may have stumbled on my problem here. I was never a long player. My God, she used to make me feel embarrassed. She used to use me to time eggs. Soft boiled. Can't help it. Fellas are like that. If fellas are like that, they can't help it. Some fellas, they make love, they go to sleep. Some fellas, that's it. It's not deliberate. Sarcasm doesn't help. I can still hear my wife's voice saying, toast takes longer than you do. And toast pops up. You are terrific. I watch the ladies, you see, because if I saw one of the ladies go, I changed the subject. I don't need to worry tonight, because you ladies have broad minds to go with your broad smiles, and it's... Trouble is, you fellas know the girls and I don't. Would it embarrass you if I said hello? Would it? Would it? Would it? No, it wouldn't. No good. Hello. May I say hello? My name is Bobby. You look gorgeous and tanned tonight. What's your first name?
Jean.
Jean. I'd say hi, Jean, but hi, Jean makes you sound like a bottle of Domestos. Is she clean round the bend? Oh, well, in that case. May I say hello, sweetheart? What's your first name?
Deborah.
Deborah. Oh, I love that name. Debbie, Debbie, Debbie. It comes from the Bible. It's in the book of Ruth, Deborah. Ah, yeah. It has a biblical meaning. Do you know the meaning of the name Deborah?
No.
It means purity. The fellow with you looks astounded. It bloody does.
That's my dad.
That's your dad. Oh, my God. Even he suspects. Oh, I see. Yes, your husband's sitting there. Well done, sir. Congratulations. It's your bloody fault, is it? Oh, you chose a good one. What's his name, darling?
John.
John, that's a good name. A good, upstanding name. What's his second name? No, I don't want to know. He hasn't got one. Was he? He hasn't got one. My God, fellas. Here's a husband here who hasn't got one, and... Deborah's sitting here all on her own. I'll let you know her chalet number before the evening's over. Hello, my sweetheart, lovely lady with two fellas. You're going to look a mess in the morning. What's your first name?
Maureen.
Maureen? Oh, I always wanted to join the Marines. Now I wish I had. Does he call you Maure for short or not very often? That's a shame. May I say hello? My name's Bobby. What's your first name?
Heather.
Darling?
Heather.
Heather. I hear you grow wild on the hills. Is that true? Oh, I hope you're lucky, honey. What's your first name?
Christine.
Christine. Mrs. Chris or Miss Chris?
Mrs.
Mrs. Chris. Happy Christmas. I've got a headache. Do you know the meaning of the name Christine?
No, I don't.
It comes from the same as Christopher or Christ. It comes from the same word as Christ, and that originally it actually means innocence. Innocence. Did you understand any of my jokes tonight, Chris?
Yes.
Shame on you, Chris. Fortunately, I have a Gideon Bible in my chalet. I shall take you there alone. Just you and I, my child, will study the scriptures throughout the night. I shall ram the fear of God into you tonight, Christine. He says, no, you bloody well won't. You get off. Do you know, These girls are lovely tonight. It's such a pleasure to be with such pretty-looking ladies. It really is. You look so lovely tonight, my darling. What's your first name?
Phyllis.
Phyllis. Your second name isn't Anne, is it? I just wondered, because I hear Phyllis Ann fortifies the over-40s. Is it really? Yes, your daughter's name, is it, Phyllis? Isn't that interesting? Ah, tell me yes or no, Phyllis, yes or no. Do you know what virgins dream about?
No.
No, it figures. Do you know, I didn't think her memory was that good, lads. She's looking good tonight. Doesn't it feel awful when you know you're next? I know. What's your first name, Pet?
Anne.
Anne, oh, I love it. There's another Anne here, Phyllis. Oh, yes, there's two Annes. That's Anne. That was the name of a panda, wasn't it? Yeah. Anne and Chi-Chi. Do you remember Anne and Chi-Chi? That goes back a bit. They tried to get her mated. She's now stuffed in the British Museum. Yeah, 8 years they tried to get her mated. She had to die before she got stuffed. That's not... It's a hard life. What's your first name, Dad? You have to follow me. I'm not a moth. Hey, poor bugger. What's your first name, honey bunch?
Sarah.
Sarah. Spelled backwards, Harris. Have you been harassed so far this holiday, have you, darling? Well, you never know. You never know your luck. You'll get to it. See, yeah. It depends. If you spell your name backwards, you often get another name. Cilla Black, spelled backwards, is carbolic. Bad choice. Yoko Ono, spelled backwards, oh, no, nookie. Try spelling your name backwards, unless your name is Val. Do you know one of the most interesting what? It's worse for Val Doonican, because Doonican spelled backwards is knackernude. That's... I feel sorry for Val Doonican. Must be miserable for the man going through life with those initials. It must be hell. He gets sympathetic letters from Victor Moon. Thank you, sir. Not many men have helped me out with my wire. Do you know... We all make mistakes, that's why they put rubbers on the end of pencils. The ladies are lovely tonight. I wish I could sing a song for you girls. I wish I could sing a little number. I tell you, I could try. Mr. Drummer Man, give me a touch of the brushes. Not too much, I might get to like it. Give me a little ching, chicka, ching, chicka, ching, chicka, 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 ching. When you hear rhythm like this, right away you got to sing. I can't remember the modern songs. It's the old songs that come back, the old songs of yesteryear that I love. Born free, my father's a doctor. What a song. She lay in her bearskin in front of the fire, nubile and naked and warm with desire. The flames hovered round her in circling rings, scorching a few of my favorite.
We only got halfway to sunny Spain. Our viva is knackered.
Keep it going. Dogs and cats and rats better scurry. Butlin's chef is making a curry. Play the music. Play the music. I wish I had one of you ladies on my arm tonight. My wife's gone right off me lately. I've got a plan to turn her back on tonight. See if you think this will work, girls. My wife's gone off me as can be. Hell, it's been 10 long nights since she last fancied me. Hey, listen, if I don't get a little loving, then our marriage will be dead. So when we get undressed tonight, I'll stand by the bed. I will stand nude by the bed. I'm gonna tie a yellow ribbon. What?
You're ahead of me, aren't you?
Can you imagine, fellas, if you got so desperate you tied a yellow ribbon there just to draw attention to yourselves? When you woke up in the morning sober, you couldn't remember doing it. You looked down, you saw the ribbon, you went, my God, don't know where I was last night, but I think I won first prize. Oh, with a great big bow, she'll be sure to see. And when she sees the ribbon, how she'll smile at me. Be just my luck if the knot gets stuck. We'll be up till three trying to get the bloody ribbon off a dear. Oh, me.
And Bob Monkhouse.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. You're sensational. I thank you from the heart of my bottom. Damn. From my bottom and my heart for being such a great audience. I thank the ladies in particular in the room for letting me let my hair down tonight, especially those sitting ringside. Thank you for allowing me to poke so much fun. Thank you for your handsome escorts not giving me a knuckle sandwich on the way round. You guys have a great sense of humor. You must have, or you wouldn't be with these girls. And I want to share your very generous support. Ladies and gentlemen, I've gone way over my time. I have a little sign from Brian. I could have two more minutes. I think that's what he meant. And I'd like to share your very generous applause, if I may, with not only three of the finest musicians in the business, also three of the nicest guys. Unfortunately, none of these six men could be here with me tonight. They're all in bed with Sid Lawrence auditioning, so instead, may I draw your unwilling attention, ladies and gentlemen, to the musical Walking Wounded of Barry Island. The masters of musical migraine you see here assembled behind me, one on bass guitar, one on keyboards, one on drums, two on cannabis, all three on probation. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff, and Chris, thank you so much, guys. Thank you, ladies. Oh, they love that applause. Don't you love that applause? Look at these eyes shining there. Oh, they'll be chatting in their chalet tonight. They'll be chattering under the blanket. They make a little tent and light their torch and go, wasn't the applause good? Wasn't the applause good? Yes, it's not the money they get. It's the clap that they get that keeps them awake nearly every night. It's been marvellous being with you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I thank you very much for your laughter and your applause. There's an atmosphere here on Barry Island, I think, that's like nowhere else in the world. But there's an atmosphere in this country that's changed. I don't know whether you feel it, but people seem to be so proud to be British again. I think it all started about 2 years ago. Just about 2 years ago, with a great event that took place in that summer. Something that lifted our hearts and made every country in the world sort of envious of us. You know what I'm talking about, I'm sure. Noel Gordon got the push from Crossroads. It's her own fault she got the sack. They caught her rehearsing, silly cow. Don't tell her I said that, for God's sake. If that gets back, she's stronger than me. No, of course, I'm talking about what happened 2 years ago on July the 29th. We're not too far past that two-year anniversary, are we? The royal wedding. Ah, oh, what a day that was. 2 years ago, there was something splendid happened to this country, and the whole world looked at us with admiration because, oh, wasn't it a thrill? Can you remember where you were? Everybody can. All the girls were looking at that thinking, oh, I hope Charlie makes it tonight. Oh, God, he's got to make it. What does he need? A following wind behind those ears? I'll pray for that. All us fellas were looking at Diana. She looked so shy, so vulnerable. She must have been nervous on the wedding night. Well, could you blame her? The last two things he'd mounted, one had dropped dead and he'd fallen off the other. It worked out all right. We can laugh about it because it worked out well, didn't it? My God. I mean, it was hardly over. They hardly announced the wedding was over before they announced the pregnancy, and everyone got excited. The Royal Navy got overexcited, as usual. They gave Prince Andrew a medal for outstanding control of his chopper. Wrong. And along came little Prince William, or as his daddy calls him, Wills. Calls him Wills because of his whiffs, I expect. I don't know. I admire the royal family, don't you, my God? Princess Anne, the John McEnroe of the royal family. Now, I like her. I think she's marvellous. People say she's horsey. She's not. I know the doctor who delivered her children. I know the fella, James Herriot, a lovely man. It's him I can't take. That Mark Phillips, he's thick, isn't he? He is dim. They call him Foggy in the palace, don't they? They do. He went to Manila to thank them for their envelopes. He's a Burke. Has to take all his clothes off to count to 21. He is thin. Hard of thinking. Now, the others, I mean, the Queen and Prince Philip, they've been marvellous the last couple of years, touring the world, getting goodwill for us, doing well for Britain. I think they're great. And do we look after them? Do we, hell? Do you know what happened a year ago this week? Do you remember? Oh, Buckingham Palace. It was open 24 hours a day to the public. That fella was walking in and out. Do you remember? It was only a year ago. Yeah. They'd never have nicked him if he'd bought his own wine. That fella. What was his name? Fagin, you're right, Fagin, Michael Fagin. With due respect to our Irish friends, it had to be a bloody Irishman, didn't it? Who else but an Irishman would climb a 13-foot wall outside Buckingham Palace, edge along 13 feet of broken glass, jump 7.5 feet onto a parapet, shin up a drainpipe 55 feet high, break into the Queen's bedroom and never even leave her a box of bloody milk tray? Good God. What a disgrace. What a disgrace. What a fiasco. What a disgrace. And Princess Margaret on the phone asking if he'd got a friend. It was pathetic. And if that wasn't bad enough, you remember what happened the following week? They discovered the Queen's bodyguard was a shirtlifter. I could not believe. There'd been two queens in the palace all that time, and we never knew. At last, we knew why Prince Philip had had to walk like that all those years. Could I have that drink? If all that wasn't enough to make you feel proud of being British, I'll tell you what was. That happened a year ago today. Thank you, Jeff. The QE2 steamed back into Southampton Harbour on August the 12th, which it has just become, last year, and carried on board 2,758 lads who had fought in the South Atlantic. It's the anniversary of that day. I don't know whether you personally think we should have fought that action in the Falklands or whether your personal view is that we shouldn't, but one thing I'm damn sure every one of us here does believe, and that is that our British boys have proved to the world they are the bravest and the best in the world. That's great. That's terrific. Well, I'm with you. We're together on that, and I'm very delighted that you applauded, and though you did, because there are two lads over towards the rear of the audience who fought in the Falklands, two Argentinian fellas, and I know how... I don't mean to make fun of what was basically a very serious business. After all, Her Majesty the Queen sent her son to the Falklands. Thank God Mrs. Thatcher didn't send hers. He never have bloody found them. Oh, dear. What about that Mark Thatcher? Where am I? Excuse me. God, he's dim. His mother's come to terms with it now. She's trying to get him a job as Arthur Scargill's chauffeur. They're even a smashing audience to talk to tonight. It's been a thrill to be with you. Because I never normally meet you face-to-face like this. I mean, I get to meet you, but through the glass of your television screen in your sitting rooms, I don't get to actually meet you properly. But here tonight, we can talk about anything and everything because we've got no children that we can embarrass you in front of. That's the trouble with TV. You can't talk like this because of the kids. But isn't it great there's no kids? Isn't it good being a grown-up? Isn't it good? Isn't it good being grown-up, staying up late and drinking stuff that makes you sick? I had a request tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I can't do it due to the size of the microphone. No. 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 No, I'm too old for novelties, no. Don't even know where you put the Duracell. So, ladies and gentlemen, I had another request. Could we do this, Jeff? Could we do My Way? Four verses and a chorus, E-flat or D-flat? Why am I telling you? The drummer takes the melody. E-flat or D-flat? Yes. Snap your fingers, let me hear the key. That's it. Ladies and gentlemen, this lovely song, I was going to do a beautiful song called I Only Have Eyes for You, but you should see what I've got for your sister. Instead, I'm going to do My Way. Now, this, you may say, how dare he sing My Way? How dare he? But I'll tell you this. You may say to yourself, My Way. That's a song which is internationally associated with the great Frank Sinatra. Relax. Many's the time that Frank has said to me personally, if you ever want to sing one of my hit songs on Barry Island, feel free. No, it's not too convincing, that story, is it? I just hope I can remember the words. I rewrote the lyric, you see. Let's see if I can remember them. I hope I can, because I've had a few drinks tonight, I'll be honest with you. In fact, when I'm not too certain if I'm sober, I give myself a little test, in case I meet the breathalyzer squad. I'll give myself that test now. If I can pass it, I know I can sing the song. Officer, I don't want to pick and fuss about. Yes, I'm okay. I played him, yes.
I've known so few. The girls I knew all had one failing. I'd plead, explain my need. My heart would bleed, all unavailing. My God, I'm not some kinky sod who bears his bod and leaps out from a byway. But no, I've not found one who'll do it. This bird told me she'd heard, she'd had the word that I was sexy when I outlined what I had in mind. She had a kind of apoplexy. She said, my God, I thought I'd seen the lot in cars and bars, once in a doorway, God on high, I'd rather die than do it your And so I went to see this doctor gent, to see this doctor down in Kent. I told him in my shy way that I was sick, because I couldn't click, I couldn't find one chick who'd do it my way. He said, my son, I've just turned 81, and I say this, not in a glum way, I'd give the lot, give all I've got, to do it some way. Navi and Taff, we were in this Chinese calf. We're a member of the staff, is a little Chinese raver. And Taff said she's a prize, from those tiny almond eyes to those oriental thighs. Couldn't you do that a favor? But I replied with patriotic pride, I'd never slide away from true and tried ways. Apart from that, it hurts me back to do it sideways. Oh, I have tried to sow my oats from far lands end up to John O'Groats, and now at last I found the one who understands my kind of fun. Oh yeah, oh yeah. And she